Faithful ready to roll. 9 hours, 15 minutes to kick off the showdown in T-Town. A milestone visit by number one Oklahoma. The perfect antidote for an embarrassing offseason and the centerpiece of today's college football landscape.
Years finally here, game day with Bubba K. Ain't nowhere to hide, so just line it up and run the play. Everybody wants to be a winner in December, but first we gotta separate contenders from pretenders. Not so fast, my friend, tell them Corso. Our show is so superior to your show. ESPN, the king of college week skin. 10 years and running for a flat towards another 10. This week, Stoop Sooners roll into Tide Town. Just as the controversy seems to have died down. But only time will tell if Sooners a solution or if the sugar visions of the Sooners is illusion.
Sponsor of college football's premier pregame show.
Good morning and welcome to the Quad on Alabama's campus. In the long history of this program, they've been number one lots of times, but they've never welcomed a number one to Tuscaloosa. Part of the Sooner Nation is here. You just can't tell them apart. Crimson all over the place in anticipation of tonight's primetime showdown on ESPN. And Mike Shula, at age 39, brings the team out through that tunnel at Bryant-Denny. For the first time, a dry day in T-Town. That's finally, good news for us. Finally. Welcome back, Chris Fowler, Lee Corso, and Kirk Herbstreit. I think our pal Bubba said it pretty well in the song there. Separating contenders from pretenders. That's what September's all about.
Well, you know what? From my coaching experience, I found that if teams are equal, the team does.
Football, you need a clicker or multiple sets. ABC has the Canes and the Gators, ESPN2, 7:15 Eastern, Maryland, Florida State, and ESPN primetime right here, Oklahoma, Alabama. The Sooners trying to clear a major hurdle on the route to the national title game. Alabama trying for a landmark win. What do you say?
Well, Alabama went to Norman last year and kept this football game close, and I think because of that success, they believe now in Tuscaloosa, they've got an outstanding chance to win this football game. The difference in this game is very simple. Oklahoma's defensive pressure. Dante Nicholson insertion into the secondary. Tommy Harris, an All-American up front. Too much defensive speed for Alabama's offense to handle. Oklahoma comes to Tuscaloosa and gives it to Alabama.
You are absolutely picking Oklahoma. How can you pick Oklahoma with all these great Tide fans?
Hey, I just...
Huh? Let me show you.
What do you got?
Uh-oh.
There you go!
Well, you're going with the Sooners. For 90 minutes, he teased.
Yeah, of course he
toyed with the hearts and minds of this people, and you turn your back on him.
Of course he's got these guys in the national
We'll be here all day. Kickoff from the Big House is coming up next. Houston and Michigan. Mark Jones and Bob Davey have the call from Ann Arbor. Enjoy the ballgame. We'll see you later on from T-Town.
So it's number one Oklahoma in town to take on the Alabama Crimson Tide. We'll be back with the opening kickoff right after this. Welcome to ESPN's College Football Saturday, celebrating 20 years of college football on ESPN. Tonight, the number one ranked Oklahoma Sooners take on the Alabama Crimson Tide. A capacity house tonight, and they have been standing for a goodly part of the pregame. Hi, everybody. Ron Franklin along with Mike Gottfried, and it is a special night because young Mike Shula has an opportunity to do something that even Baird never did, and that is face off against the number one team in this arena, and he has a chance to come away with a win. But that is a tall order, particularly with Oklahoma's defense, Mike.
Ron, one of the best defenses I've ever seen on tape. They have eight defensive linemen led by Tommy Harris, the All-American. Two great linebackers, Lehman and Mitchell, a great corner, and Derek Strait. So they have a good, solid defense. They're fast, and they can run. They've got strength. What Alabama has to do is not get in third and long yardages against this defense. Well, they'll get to and invite the blitz from Oklahoma, so they got to stay out of that.
Bob Stoops, in his fifth year, Mike, has already won a national championship, hoping that possibly his Sooners might make it two in his first 5 years. And Mike Shula making his first appearance here at this stadium as a head coach. He, of course, has made many appearances here as his starting quarterback. And we only mention the weather because right now it's very nice, and it looks as though it's going to be mild. But down at the bottom, the forecast, possibly isolated thunderstorms. There are some in the area, and we will keep an eye on that for you. Oklahoma has won the toss. They have deferred, and it will be Alabama receiving as Trey DiCarlo prepares to kick it off. Ramsey Robinson and Ray Hudson, the two deep men. Robinson on the near side, Hudson on the far side, 17 and 27. You talk about anticipation and noise for a couple of days in this city. These folks have been revved and ready to see this one happen. We are too. Here comes DiCarlo. Underway. Number one, Oklahoma and the Crimson Tide of Alabama, and Robinson will not return this one. So let's take a look at the starters tonight.
The battle. Two really solid defenses going at it.
Crowd again is up and cheering on this Alabama defense. Kevon Jones operates a tailback this time. He gets the handoff on the sweep. Nothing there. Tries to cut it back inside. Nice job by Freddie Roach. Adrian Karsten, what do you have for us?
I did make contact with the medical staff of Alabama as they were taking Shaud Williams into the locker room. Again, due to new federal regulation, I cannot give you any information they don't give me. But the inside to his right wrist is probably going to require x-rays. That's all I have at this point.
Clock runs, 4 minutes and 17, now 4 minutes and 16 seconds. And in this quarter, instead of good field position, Oklahoma's had poor field position. They throw the middle screen, big opening here, 30, 35, 40, Mark Bradley. And Bradley finally pushed out of bounds by Roman Harper. And a long gainer on the part of the Sooners, and they flip the field as it's good for 35 yards.
Quick screen out to the left. Mark Bradley's going to get this in your right, Ron. He got some great blocks. He got a good block by Mark Clayton, the wide receiver, and flips the field in coverage. Roman Harper makes the play. I just think about Oklahoma. They have only had 105 yards rushing last week. Haven't been able to run the ball that well this game.
You see the numbers on White. Going to go up the sideline. Fade route, got a man wide open at the 10-yard line, and he will score, Mark Clayton. Charles Jones got roasted, 46 yards on the play.
I don't know if they busted the coverage or they weren't set, but Clayton looked like he was all alone.
Sooners will not go for two. They will kick the extra point. Trey DiCarlo lines it up, trying to put Oklahoma up by 10. He's got it perfect, right down the middle. Three plays, 81 yards. It only needed 70 or 61 seconds. We'll take a timeout. New score, Oklahoma 13-3. Teammates asking, what's the difference between Tuscaloosa and Lubbock? And he pointed up, he said, see all these trees? They don't have those things out there in West Texas.
are not nearly as many of them.
Doyle now throws it long. Broken assignment right up and throws him. 30, 25, and finally pushed out of bounds by Dante Nicholson. Good for 42 yards. Somebody had to have blown one there, Mike.
That's what you need, oh. You need a big play against those guys. Lance Mitchell, the linebacker, came across him, and I don't know if he was supposed to pick him up or not, but Fulgham wide open.
Turned him loose and then tried to catch up with him. You can see him right there, and it was too late.
Again, Alabama's players feel like they're in better condition than any other football team in the country. Second half is theirs.
Deepest penetration of the night by the Crimson Tide. And now Broyle, deep drop, far sideline, drills the pass, touchdown to Yambus Luke. Straight had the coverage and he couldn't handle it. Triandus with a 20-yard touchdown, and the extra point attempt coming right now as Alabama tries to make it a 3-point margin. Bostic, good pass, kick right down the middle.
Alabama beat the best. And Derek Straight, Brandis Luke, you're going to see the tight end come down and move out. You're going to see the post by Luke and beat Straight right here. Tight end occupies the safety, and then he bends out. Post route comes wide open to Brandis Luke.
And Mike, perfectly thrown. I mean, it just, look at the trajectory on this ball.
Beautifully thrown ball. Good protection. Everything was right.
Well, this crowd is back to frenzy mode, which is the way they started the night.
Pretty good drive. They needed big plays. If they got a great drive, good call again by Mike Shula.
Six plays, 80 yards, a minute, 28 seconds. And Luke with the 20-yard touchdown catch. Two of the most storied programs in college football. Last year at Oklahoma, the Alabama people commented about how much they enjoyed seeing the OU traditions and to see and listen to their crowd. And I have a feeling tonight, although they probably don't enjoy this only 3-point margin now, but they're seeing an eye-opening affair here, because if you've never been to a game in Tuscaloosa, it's a happening, folks. And I know tomorrow is the religious day, but the religious day in this state begins tonight and goes through tomorrow. Jeff Hall to kick it off for the Crimson Tide. Very high, and this one is returnable. From the 3-yard line is Rankins. Rankins gets free across the 30 to the 32. 29 yards on the return. Thurman Ward was there to make the play. Sooners got away with a block in the back on that return.
Jason White, 12 out of 24. And the thing, because you can't run the football, you can't run the clock. So the quarterback in the passing game's got to get the first downs and hurry the clock along. But Alabama's defense played as well as Oklahoma's defense in this football game.
Vince Carter continues to operate at the center for the Sooners. Draw play, ran into his own blocker, and the man who made the tackle was actually Wes Sims. They were pulling him out on the play, and Jones, who was only 5'9", 187, watched this collision.
Now this is a tackle in the backfield.
Wes just out there trying to do his job, but he weighs 317 and he knocked his own guy down.
When you hit somebody at 317, they're going to go down.
from the shotgun. White gets it complete to the 30-yard line. Travis Wilson, and that was quite a stick by the D'Amico Ryans. And now this crowd is just going into orbit. It is going to be third down, and the line to make is out to the 42-yard line.
We talked about the secondary of Oklahoma making good tackles. Secondary and the linebackers of Alabama will wrap you up, too. Those guys look like they're enjoying this. And that's the confidence you get as a quarterback when your coach is a former quarterback.
Oklahoma's going to have to hurry. They only have one timeout left for the entire game. Down to 3 seconds, got it off. Now here comes the pressure. Throws it in. It is caught at the 40-yard line. Nope, he did not get his feet in bounds. Brandon Jones went so high that he could not get a foot down. Being a great athlete, actually got him in trouble, Mike. Watch this play here.
I don't think he had the football.
No, didn't have possession.
Remember, Alabama has blocked a punt. They got their hand on a punt.
You can see the ball being transferred from left hand to right. And as a result, the official had to call him out. Six times, OU has had to punt this evening. Here they come right up the middle. And they're going to throw a pass, and it's complete at the 30-yard line. 40, 45 to the 50. Michael Thompson. And how about that gamble by Coach Stoops? 24 yards.
When you have a defense like he's got, that's still the gamble. Because he knew Alabama's going to come after this punt. Now everybody has a man. You still have somebody on the man-for-man coverage. But a great call by Bobby Stoops. Set up perfect.
Blake Ferguson with the pass.
Michael Thompson with the catch.
And you could see Ferguson, he wasn't worried about aesthetics. He just wanted to make sure he got it to the proper spot, which he did. Kevon Jones, number 20, ports in at tailback. It's Reynolds in motion. Oklahoma going to go for it all, heading for the end zone, and it is caught at the 5 and touchdown, Brandon Jones. 47 yards in the pass play. You made the point last week. Great teams come back with the retort, and they came back very quickly.
You got to go back to the fake punt. That was a great call. And then you got Alabama sitting back a little bit because they just got bit on the fake punt, and then you throw the strike to Brandon Jones. Two great play calls by Chuck Long and his head coach, Bobby Stoops.
Jason White and his ability to throw with great touch on the long pass.
And long ball is perfect.
Really impressive. Really impressive. DiCarlo with the extra point attempt. He's got it.
When you're on the road, you got to do things like that.
4:31 remaining, third quarter, and our new score at a hushed Bryant Denny Stadium. As you look at Brandon Jones, it is Oklahoma 20, Alabama 10.
Alabama two turnovers, zero for Oklahoma.
And that is the end of the third quarter. So as we head to period number four, the number one team in the nation still with a 10-point lead over Alabama. We'll be right back. 29, now 28 seconds. They're going to have to run one more play, and this one will go in the record books. And he'll take a knee. So the Oklahoma Sooners are now 2-0 on this young season. Mike Shula goes to 1-1, loses his first game here at Bryant-Denny Stadium. So the final score, Oklahoma 20, Alabama 13, coming up next at SportsCenter and ESPN News Postgame Extra. For more, log on to ESPN.com, your home for college football on the Internet. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Right now, we say so long from...